Basically, where we're headed very soon is tens of thousands of robots operating in our conflicts. Robots are emotionless, so they don't get upset if their buddy is killed. They don't commit crimes of rage and revenge. But robots are emotionless. They see an 80-year-old grandmother in a wheelchair the same way they see a T-80 tank. They're both just a series of zeros and ones.
Fully autonomous robotic weapons that make lethal decisions about human beings all on their own. The Pentagon's Gorgon, Stara, and Argus programs will put up to 65 independently operated camera eyes on each drone platform. And this would vastly outstrip human ability to review it. And that means visual intelligence software will need to scan it for items of interest. And that means very soon drones will tell humans what to look at, not the other way around.
Computers control everything in your car. They control your phone. They control our nation's entire infrastructure. It's everything from missile silos to satellites to nuclear defense networks. And when something goes wrong, cyber can make all of these things impossible.
Just as software has gone open source, so has warfare. Good guys might play around and work on these as hobby kits, but so might bad guys. This cross between robotics and things like terrorism is going to be fascinating and even disturbing.
Suppose a terrorist wants to blow up a building. He's going to use a cell phone as a remote detonator. A well-crafted cyber attack could break into his phone, cause a battery to overheat and explode. No more phone, no more detonator, maybe no more terrorist, all with the press of a button from 1,000 miles away.
This raises the very real possibility of anonymous war. It could make military action a viable option, not just for small nations, but criminal organizations, private enterprise, even powerful individuals.
When historians look at this period, they're going to conclude that we're at a different type of revolution, a revolution in war, like the invention of the atomic bomb. But it may be even bigger than that, because our unmanned systems don't just affect the how of war fighting, they affect the who of fighting at its most fundamental level.